What is grunge? Is that another reason for you staying? Grunge can be considered an offshoot of sludge metal. It could be seen as a hybrid of sludge metal and alternative rock. But I'm a creep. It began in the late 80s and got popular in the 90s. Melvins tend to be thought of as the original grunge band. Sludge runs thick in its veins. Ask not if you won't find it right. Yet the alt-rock influence is also felt. Nirvana were heavily influenced by this sound for their first record, Bleach, which is much more sludgy than their later material. Nevermind, however, tends to be viewed as the most iconic grunge record, as it is more emblematic of the style, being a balanced synthesis of the elements that make up grunge. On In Utero, Nirvana leaned more towards the alt-rock side of the spectrum. These three albums capture the full range of sound that grunge is capable of being. Perhaps even more so than In Utero, Pearl Jam are definitely leaning more towards alt-rock. You'd have a difficult time selling the idea that they are metal at all to most people. The same goes for Stone Temple Pilots. And I feel the time's a waste of gold. It used to be that you loved me, but now it's 1990. However, Soundgarden is much more in line with metal, being influenced by stoner rock. Pick it up. Of course, the most metal grunge band is Alice in Chains, as they are also inspired by sludge metal. Yeah! Hard rock. And don't murder me, but yes, glam metal. Put you down. So the difference between Pearl Jam and Alice in Chains is night and day. I should also distinguish grunge from post-grunge. Post-grunge is a much cleaner version of grunge, a sterilized, radio-friendly edition. This includes bands like Foo Fighters and Nickelback. Hey, I wanna be a rock star. Yes, post-grunge is just the fancy name for butt rock, and it lacks any edge that grunge had. If grunge is already in a gray area as far as whether or not it is metal, post-grunge absolutely is not metal. That said, however, many alternative metal bands in the early 2000s took influence from post-grunge, such as 3 Days Grace, and Seether. Nu metal also took heavy influence from grunge, notably Korn, who spawned the style. There is a lot of crossover between styles, so hopefully that clears up some confusion. Now, back to grunge proper. Grunge had a huge cultural significance and represented a sort of paradigm shift. It had such an impact that it is often considered its own style, distinct from metal, punk, and alt-rock, which is pretty incredible when you think about how short grunge's heyday was and how few grunge bands there are compared to metal, punk, and alternative bands. Tenacious D even has a song talking about metal triumphing over grunge, which is pretty funny. Grunge tried to kill the metal. They failed! Grunge even became a sort of movement, as well as an aesthetic, which is still used by e-girls to this day. What marks grunge as significant is how it tapped into the cultural zeitgeist. In the last video, I described the theme of sludge metal as a sort of existential angst. This is true of grunge as well, but in a much more subdued and complacent way. there is a withdrawn apathy to grunge. I'm so happy, 'cause today found my friend. Humanity was coming to the end of a millennium, yet instead of excitement, this last decade, before the new era, the 90s, was greeted with a whatever attitude, which is still commonly associated with Gen X to this very day. Grunge itself is a hodgepodge of other rock styles, and even this is symbolic of its uncaring attitude. It doesn't even try to stick out as its own thing. Lyrically, a lot of grunge songs make little sense, and often contain self-refuting, contradictory passages. I will stress that this isn't to say that grunge songs are meaningless. I've made this mistake before of implying that, and I deeply regret that. However, what I will say is that grunge is cynical. When I wake up in my makeup, have you ever felt so used up as this? It often contains meta self-referential moments that mock rock music itself. It is not time to make it unclear, to write off lines. Grunge is quite deconstructive and postmodern in this sense. In Utero especially is extremely cynical towards the music industry itself, with some of the track titles, such as Radio Friendly Unit Shifter, which is mocking the idea of how songs are just products used to sell albums. Then there's, well, this. Rape me, my friend. Which I swear exists just to troll people. The fact that this record was by the most popular rock band in the world at that time says a lot about the vibe of that era. The word Nirvana means enlightenment, which itself is pretty ironic. Society was at its so-called peak in the 90s.
Coming to bed, honey?
Yes, dear.
And it left people thinking, this is it? People were underwhelmed. They were jaded by what was sold to them compared to how things really were.
Hey! No stairway. Denied.
There is something quite Dadaist about grunge. The end of the 20th century marking the end of the era of enlightenment. It was nonsensical on purpose, but this does not make it meaningless. The popularity of grunge indicated a collective indifference for the future. That's not to say it's bad. In fact, despite its irony and provocative insincerity, it somehow remains one of the most authentic art forms of the time. Come as you are, as you were. However, perhaps it's for the best that metal triumphed over grunge in the end. Something in the way. Grunge then tried to dethrone the metal, but metal was in the way. But grunge still deserves a mention as a part of metal history. Thank you for joining me on my quest to uncover all of metal's overcomplicated genres.
Yeah!